Lock and low.
Hello.
Oh, hello. KFMA Day. Hello, hello, Carolina. Sitting here with the gentleman of swimmers. Welcome to Tucson again.
Hello,
thank
hi.
You. Thanks for so having much. Us.
I feel
thank
like you, we're yes. old friends. We've hung out in the studio.
We have. We are. Yeah, we go way back.
You sang specially to me.
We did.
And everybody else on the internet.
Yeah. I remember being there when you were born.
Oh, wow. You have mastered time travel, sir. Well, let's talk about it. What are you most looking forward to today?
Honestly, I'm looking forward to having a bunch of new people check us out for the first time.
The kids of Tucson.
And honestly, Disturbed is pretty dope.
Yeah, I'm excited for that one moment when all of a sudden we just hear
10,000 people going for it.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be insane, right?
Yeah. It'll be good.
So I want to talk, I do a little segment called Rock Talk every day on our morning show. And basically what I do is I give people information about the bands that we play.
Oh. Cool.
So I want some inside scoop from you guys, but I don't want you to tell me information about yourselves. I want you to tell me about the other guys in the band. Like, for example, I specifically own over 100 rubber ducks.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow. Yeah, I know. It's kind of weird.
Collector.
So tell me weird and quirky things about everybody.
Seb has 10 cats back home. He's a cat lady.
What are all the names? I'm a cat person.
Joseph, Mark.
Barabbas.
What?
Remember Barabbas?
Yeah, Barabbas. Well, Barabbas isn't around anymore.
Oh.
So Travis, Mark, who else? Oh, my God, there's so many.
Douglas. Ursula.
Daisy, Ursula, Carl, Tom. Fridge. Do we already do Tom?
No, you got Travis, Mark, and Tom.
Travis, Mark, and Tom. Yeah, I got the Blink-182 cats. And then, who am I missing? Michael, Sarah, and Linda.
Well, we can tell that Michael, Sarah, and Linda are your favorites.
Yeah, they are. I feel kind of bad. Sorry, Michael, Sarah, and Linda.
All right, so he outed you. Now throw one out.
Well, Cole's actually, he's actually gone, what's it called again? Is it paragliding? The one where, like, you hang on the, like, kite and you fly?
Yeah.
Is that paragliding?
Oh, nice.
Cole's done paragliding a couple times.
Cole's super talented. And he's also really coordinated, so like he's probably the only person we trust doing that.
Yeah, paragliding. I mean, he's only done it a couple times, but I'm pretty jealous. No one really knows that. Like, he told me he was going to do like a paragliding lesson. It's like one where you're strapped into the guy, you know?
Yeah. It was. I try to keep it on the down low because I don't want people to think I'm like a crazy guy. Yeah. But
well, don't worry. I won't tell anybody. No one will know. Just right here and everybody that's listening.
All right, Cole. What about Max? What do we have to say about Max? Wow, where do we begin?
Max believes in Big Brother.
1989 by George Orwell.
Big Brother.
You know those really weird Vietnam vets that you sometimes run into? Max has somehow like adopted the personality of one of those.
Mm-hmm. I just don't trust him.
They're all watching. The internet. Watching. Bad.
It's good. It's good to be skeptical and cynical of the world.
So I want to talk for a minute. Swimmers is the fourth band name. Is that correct?
It's been a bunch. Right, it's been a bunch.
I want to focus on Emily's Army. Tell me more about that, because I know that one's got a special place in your heart.
Yeah. Well, we used to be in a band called Emily's Army. We kind of like changed lineups when we became Swimmers. So we just kind of call it like a new band. But Emily's Army is really special to us because Max, my cousin, has cystic fibrosis.
And she's Emily.
Her name is Emily. And so we kind of, like, the idea was to raise awareness and visibility for her while also having a really cool band name.
We raised a bunch of awareness over the... We were Emily's Army for about 6 years or something.
So yeah, actually, our mom is getting honored as, like, the person of the year for the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation because she's done so much for it.
That's awesome. So,
yeah, it was cool. It was a good time. I mean, like... I'm really stoked to be Swimmers now because we just musically we're all like really happy with what we're doing, and Seb's in the band, which is like incredible. And,
oh, thank you.
So we're all having
the
a good
feels up here. The feels.
Oh yeah.
So
it's actually a little bit more aggressive than that. I'd say it's more of a spice than a feels. It's like less romantic between us. It's more just like extreme
fiery.
passion.
So one last thing. Last time you guys were here, we talked about the parents possibly being out in the mosh pit today.
Oh, my God.
Did moms, dads show up for the show today? Or we?
I know my dad, Mosh Pit Mark, would love to be here. He's like
he's in Mexico.
That's his nickname among many circles is just because he's the least likely person to enjoy it. But for some reason, every time we play a show, he's in there with like all the 16-year-old, 17-year-old kids just going nuts.
No, we're out here solo today in Tucson, and you are the only person we know.
Oh, I'll take it. That means I've got a pretty good chance of being the coolest person you know in
Tucson.
Yeah,
oh, yeah, yeah.
True.
I'm all right with that. Well, guys, I'm so excited you're here today for KFMA Day.
We're stoked.
Go out there and rock their faces off today.
Thank you. It's going to be fun.
Thank you.